Welcome back to the Trading Desk. I'm here again with our co-host, Nicole Mentines, and we're back with an action-packed Trading Desk this week. We've got two live guests in the office that have made their way from the Carolinas.
Extremely interesting, too. Very well-traveled and...
Both south, and one was a motorcycle ride all the way from Charlotte, and then David Buffalo is joining us also from Greenville, South Carolina area. We're going to talk about margin today. We're going to talk about trading margin. We're going to talk about different strategies. We've got, again, an interview with another trader, David Buffalo, along with an exciting new book that I'm writing with our other guest, Tamala Rich, and we'll be talking about kind of the trade-offs, the longs and shorts of life, and how to apply a trader's mentality to life.
Life transitions, life deciding transition. What's best for you, regardless
exactly.
of money.
Exactly. So before we do that, we're going to take you to the charts and take a look at what happened over the last couple weeks. And we'll be back with David Buffalo on the other side to talk about trading strategies and trading on margin. What does it mean?
Recap the charts real quick. We'll start with the euro on the left. We're going to be showing the daily charts, and then on the right chart is the last 20 days of trading, or a one-month chart. We've bounced very hard here off the bottom. We said last time that the 118 level probably would be the bottom for probably the remainder of 2010, as long as that holds. And then we held 121 again when we were coming on air last time, and we've shot up nearly 1,200 pips since then. So the euro has definitely put in a bottom here. It looks solid to us, and we'll continue to watch that. The next chart we want to show, of course, is the ES, or the S&P futures. Again, you can see on the daily chart, we put the high back in here in April, late April of 1216, and we have just been walking down one, two, three lower highs now, and we've made one, two, three lower successive lows. And right now we're at a juncture here mid-July where we're either going to make a new low again or finally get up, maybe bounce to that 1130 area. So we're watching, we're right in the middle of this range. If we go below 1000, we could see 950. We've been looking for that all year. That 950 range has been our target. 1000 has been the number so far. 1000 to 1230 has been the range that we've traded in. We are down for the year as far as the S&P goes, and this pretty much mimics what we're seeing in the dollar now here also. The dollar rallied hard, as we were suggesting on the trading desk last fall. Dave and Jesse were suggesting buy, really for a few months. It took some months for that to happen, and then we took off like a rocket from 74 all the way up to $89 on the dollar, and that's obviously had a solid. A pullback here to the 79.80 level, it looks to be, in turn, you see a lot of support there, and I can see that happening over the next few months. The next chart real quickly, again, lumber. We want to bring this up as it pertains to the local economy here in Bend. Lumber is again showing weakness. It bounced a little bit off this 180 level to the 220 level, and now is falling back, trading now below 200. Lumber is telling me that the housing market has not bottomed, and we will see lower prices moving forward. And finally, real quick, oil. If we see any type of action coming into the Mideast, any type of airstrikes from Israel or the U.S., on Iran later this fall, as I think we may see, just to get the economy spurred again, I could see oil spiking, which would again put another nail in the coffin on the already struggling economy. So that's where we are. You're watching COTV, the Trading Desk, and we'll be back on COTV with David Buffalo to talk about trading strategies when we return. You're watching COTV Channel 11.